Hey everyone, this is my video on projectors. Projectors are one of the five main aura types in human design. And in a quick 1 minute summary, I'm going to talk about is going to be how projectors are meant to operate in this world. Projectors ultimately are the guides. Projectors do not have a sacral center closed, so they have to be very careful about how they manage their energy. They always need to defer to their authority in terms of who, what invitations they respond to. Just because they are invited in does not mean that they are to actually respond to that. They are always to respond based on what they actually can guide in, whether or not it is a yes for them based on their authority, and a variety of other factors. Projectors, because they do not have a sacral center, can drain themselves and can get sucked in to other people's energies because of so many open centers that they have. So they have to be really careful about listening to their authority. Ultimately, though, projectors are the guides. And in the new era that we were going to be entering into in 2027, they are meant to be the ones that are the new teachers. Whereas in the past, it had been manifestors. In the past, it was kind of a top-down model where the person at the top built, where now it's everyone building together in a community way and the projectors guiding the process. I hope that helps. If you want to learn more about projectors and what I have to say about projectors, stay tuned for the rest of this video. And if you're interested in human design aura types in general, either for yourself or business partner or someone you may be in close contact with and you want to understand how they interact with you, then feel free to check out the rest of my series on human design aura types. Projector is someone who looks like this. There are three types of projectors. There are classic projectors, energy projectors, and mental projectors. And since this is a high level, I'm not going to go into that, but that is all dependent on which energy centers and motor centers different projectors have. So projectors are rare, but they're not as rare as manifestors. Rough back of the envelope, people say, is that projectors represent about 20% of the population. And projectors are here to be the guides. So if you were new to human design and you were to jump onto Instagram, you would think that every single person who does human design is a projector, or everybody on planet Earth is a projector, because coaches are often projectors. Now, the reality is not only projectors are here to be coaches or guides, because there are a ton of projected channels and gates, and it's all to depend on what you have activated in your particular design that's going to speak to what you are here to do, as well as your profile. But the projectors are here to guide. And I mentioned this in some of my prior videos, but in an ideal world, manifestors would start things, generators would build things, that includes manifesting generators, projectors would guide, and reflectors would kind of reflect on how the situation is going, kind of having a very different perspective than everybody else because their aura types are all open. Projectors, like manifestors, which is the prior video I did in the series, check out that video if you are interested in that. They also do not have a closed sacral, so they do not have consistent access to their energy center. And like manifestors, this can be kind of taken over by generators or people who have a closed sacral. So they need to kind of constantly be clearing this out and making sure they're resting and making sure they are not trying to keep up with some of the other types. Unlike manifestors who just kind of go do it, projectors are here to guide by invitation only. Their invitation is not the same as generators. Projectors will get a formal invitation by likely a generator that they want to be guided or mated with, or asked to do business with, etc. And it is the formal invitation that projectors are waiting for. And there are multiple types of authority for projectors. They are to default to their authority as to what invitations they take on. Just because they are invited, one, is it in their wheelhouse, meaning it is it part of their profile design to do? If you're a 6'3" and you try to guide in something that you don't have earned experience in as a 3-line, you might struggle a little bit, right? Because someone is going to ask you to guide them, but they're probably in the business realm or in the practical realm of where I play going to ask you to guide them in something, right? If they're asking you to guide them as a life coach, that might be different. Where you're just seeing their aura and you're able to kind of intuit about the direction they need to head. But if they're asking you to guide them in something that's a little bit more applied, you better have foundational knowledge, 1, 2, or 3, based off of your profile type. And if you're interested in learning more about the profile lines, I have a video that I did on that as well. Apologize, I'm looking all over the place. I'm still kind of getting used to working with cameras and webcams and all that. I have more 3 lines in my chart than anything, so I kind of just do stuff and roll with it. So as you can see in our example, the only thing I want you to take from this example, this is one projector, is just this part. It's just the fact that they have an open sacral. And you can see that they have a lot of open centers. Projectors generally have a lot of open centers. What else do I want you to know about projectors? Projectors, we talked about deconditioning. Projectors, much like manifestors who are not the majority of the population, but they are still a significant percentage of the population, are going to suffer from a lot of the conditioning that manifestors might have suffered from, where they're trying to operate in a generator world. And so this can show up in a variety of ways. This could show up where they are trying to keep up with generators. You know, we have a work day and a work ethic and a hustle culture that's been based off of, you know, the manufacturing industry and shifts. And projectors don't work that way, right? They have on and off. They don't have a closed sacral. So they can push themselves. They can push themselves to do that, and then they're going to burn out and make themselves sick. Projectors may learn differently. Projectors may process information differently. And so as children, they may have been labeled as slow or different. And so that is another conditioning, right? Because we have the conditioning we're put on as children and in family. We have the conditioning of society. And then we are individually conditioned on a daily basis through our centers. Some of that conditioning can be good because we're receiving information we might not otherwise and ideas we might not otherwise, but it's just careful to be, it's a time of discernment and a time to be aware. And just applying this down to business, projectors are often coaches and guides and their roles in business. It's more about, you might be able to see a process that needs to be fixed or an operations flow that's not working, or you might look at a team and say, this person needs to be here, this person needs to be here, because you can see auras and you can see the bigger picture. Really stepping into that can be useful. You know, I had a client who was a projector and no doubt had a lot of business partners who are not a projector. And once I was able to explain to him what his strengths as a projector were, his way of dealing with conflict, or let's say expectations of his business partners, shifted. And it was a game changer. And all of a sudden, he was recognized for who he is and who he was. And think about how different that dynamic for a company that's not a new company, and he's known these guys for years, all of a sudden he's been able to shift the dynamic in the way that they see him. How powerful is that, right? So aura type is very powerful. It is one component, but there is a reason why Ra, or Alan Krakauer, as I call him, said that profile and authority are where you start. Because if you know your aura type, you know your role in the world. If you decide to do nothing else with human design, you could get a lot of mileage out of it, as I just gave an example in my prior client. So projectors are here to guide. They can see aura types. They are not here to try to keep up with generators. There are 3 types, and that's going to be based off of whether or not they have closed centers open, whether or not they have motor centers below the throat. That's getting a little bit more into specifics. But all projectors have the same not self, which is bitterness. The same self, which is satisfaction, and they're here to respond to invitation. And something that comes up a lot in business, people who are business owners, is waiting to respond to an invitation is not the same as waiting for life to come to you. I'm a big believer in law of attraction. I'm a big believer in synchronicity. I'm a big believer in astrology and human design. Otherwise, I wouldn't be doing this channel. But if you've watched any other videos on this channel, you know that as a 5-1 heretic, I kind of spin things differently and I don't take anything at face value. Mindset is very powerful. And if human design or astrology is going to affect your mindset to the point where you think you can't do this, you can't do that, then feel free to throw the playbook out the window, because nothing is more powerful than your mindset, and nothing is more powerful than conditioning yourself to think that you can't do something. So as a projector, you are here to take in and accept invitations that are a heck yes for you based on of your authority. But that doesn't mean you're not supposed to put yourself out there. You could go on, you know, you could be a guest on a podcast or have a blog or, you know, have marketing vehicles. You live on the earth plane. And I want to make sure that that is something we're always coming back to on this channel, on my channel, is we're on the earth plane and how are we applying this in a practical way? So you want to give people the opportunity to respond to you, and the way that you might market yourself might be based off of your profile type and your lines. But if people don't know about you, they can't respond to you. So that is a key distinction that I want to emphasize. I'm losing the light. As we know, projectors guide, and they often guide people in the dark. So they are a very, very useful part of the framework of human design and of the human experience. I hope you're enjoying the series on human design. If you have not yet checked out the video on Human Design 101, I will link it below, and maybe it'll show up here depending on how many more of these I got to show up. Again, this is a basic series. So comment down below, ask questions, like this video if it speaks to you, and you want to see more content like this, and you want to see content like this shared on YouTube. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.